tribes and colors.
With a talent to create value from opportunities.
I am Jacob Mercy. We are entrepreneurial leaders dedicated to taking action
and enabling social, economic, and environmental impact.
I am Ojata Onipojo Grace.
We are strong people.
Though we face challenges, yet we've not given up.
Coming the world back together as one. Standing tall to make my Nigeria proud. I am Emmanuela Osoyibo. And together we are.
And that's a Federal Polytechnic in that. We've got a story. A story that breaks our hearts. A story that we will tell generations to come. The pandemic story. An unforeseen disaster. An outbreak of war between human and virus, killing over 700,000 people. A new lifestyle was launched during the COVID-19 outbreak, forcing humans indoors without the doors being locked, dictating the rules of physical appearance, taking away the joy of meetings and visits. Schools and worship centers were locked down, taking away the right to social media. Economies of nations were destabilized due to the lockdown of business centers. COVID-19 has not only brought great harvest oil to our country and the world at large, it also brought social and economic challenges. With the closed market and businesses,
made it impossible for sellers to sell their products and for buyers to buy what they need. Knowing fully well that citizens of our dear country will need consumables to survive during this lockdown,
we at Enactus FBI saw this as a serious challenge. Staying at home is surely a good way to curtail the spread of the virus.
How do people survive with the hunger and discontinuity in business?
They need money and food to stay safe.
Ladies and gentlemen, after a series of brainstorming sessions,
we came up with an innovative solution to ensure the continuity of business and also help people to access foodstuffs across the country.
The Faster Delivery Scheme.
We present Project Pimpi, Positive Impact, Positive Change. This project is designed to solve the social and economic challenge of the pandemic and to ensure a better life after the pandemic. To address the social challenge, community sensitization was launched. This sensitization entails a huge social media engagement on the right knowledge about the virus. This was done through one-on-one communication with the communities around Nigeria to sensitize them on how to prevent the spread of the virus.
Amazingly, after the launch of this community sensitization challenge, we had volunteers from different parts of the country who were eager to join our campaign. These volunteers are professionally trained and assigned to different stages of our Enactus team for this sensitization.
Economically, we have created a platform called Easy Access, which connects buyers and sellers, ensuring that businessmen and women can go on with their businesses and customers are satisfied by still being able to get what they need.
To get this done, we provided hotlines to cover 5 states within Nigeria, which are
East States, Benue State, Enugu State, Kaduna State, and Abuja Air City. We went massively using our social media platform, advertised this easy access business. We also visited some rural communities in this state to educate the market women on how to sell to a larger market, even on non-market days.
We didn't stop here. We went further to identify 5 specific products of rice, beans, garri, palm oil, and vegetable oil.
When an order is placed using our hotline, our easy access agents sort those orders and contact the sellers who get those products ready and pass them on to the delivery persons that get this product delivered to their appropriate locations.
Distinguished audience, we are glad to announce that our project Pimpi has impacted the social and economic challenge of the pandemic.
As people can now perform their usual business activities from home, positively changing people's perspective about online visibility for their business. We successfully sensitized over 35 communities across Nigeria with 25 active volunteers, delivered more than 70 goods to customers
in different states of the country. While solving this need, we did not neglect the business aspect.
For every product delivered, there is a 5% charge from the seller and a 5% charge from the buyer through the delivery fee.
I'll join you, Nobel, as we made it to the top 7 of Act Foundation Leadership Challenge, receiving a grant of 100,000. This grant came as a blessing as it enabled us to further advance our project by first customizing a polo for easy identification and organization. We went further to identify strategic sellers who were eager to develop their businesses with our help.
My name is Idris Salisu. I'm staying in Makurdi Modern Market here in Benue State. I sell rice, beans, millet, maize, anything grains. But I specialize more on rice and beans. When COVID-19 started earlier, you know, due to the lockdown, there was no sales at all. So because the market don't used to open as for then, so we barely sell anything. But with the intervention of Easy Access Agent, I think things were much easier. Today I can sell my product even without seeing my customers. So Easy Access are very easy.
This and more are our success stories. We are ensuring the sustainability of our project to start up our own logistic company to supply goods to our customers as the fastest possible. We are in the process of building website to ensure that all these businesses have a better online presence. The database of our buyers and sellers in both the rural and urban setting, we are building a continuity for this business.
For the jobs provided for our in-access students who work as Easy Access agents, for the delivery persons who now have more runs and delivery to do per day, for the businesses that have continued despite the economic situation, for an opportunity to be part of this global transformation. So, Act Foundation in Access Nigeria, we say thank you.